Hey, what's up guys? I'm Tiger with Tiger Uppercut Media, back with another Dokkan Battle video. So, about 2 hours ago, I put out a video where I essentially was breaking down this upcoming world tournament on Global, right? But I just realized after posting the video that I completely forgot to talk about a few other things that are also coming to Global with this tournament, namely the AGL Granpa Gohan, the SR Invisible Man, as well as a Dokkan Awakening to the STR World Tournament Super Saiyan Vegeta. So in today's video, I want to quickly break those down for you guys as well. And without further ado, let's jump right into it. So as you can see at the very top here, we have the World Tournament rewards this time around, the Int Caulifla, as well as the Tech Kale. Both of them are very, very good units, but I'm not going to get into them in this video because I already mentioned them or, you know, went over them in the previous one, right? So if you guys are curious about what they do, then make sure to check out the other video from, like I said, about 2 hours ago. And as far as the stuff I forgot to talk about, let's start with the AGL Granpa Gohan first. His leader skill is AGL types Q plus 2, HP, attack, and defense plus 50%. Super attack is Kamehameha, which causes supreme damage and greatly lowers enemy's defense. His passive is attack and defense plus 100% and Ki plus 3 and high chance of evading enemy's attack, including super attack, when there is an ally or enemy whose name includes Goku Youth, or essentially Kid Goku, plus an additional attack and defense plus 80% for 3 turns after evading an attack. So this guy does not have a Dokkan Awakening, at least when he first releases, but as you can see, even without a Dokkan Awakening, he's still really, really solid, man. Attack and defense plus 100% with no conditions, which is already very good, but he also gets Ki plus 3 and a high chance to evade all enemy attacks if you have Kid Goku on your team or as an enemy. And then once he dodges an attack, he gets attack and defense plus 80% on top of the 100% for 3 turns. So very solid unit. Those are all the details. Oh, links for the Granpa Gohan, Supreme Warrior, All in the Family, Turtle School, Kamehameha, Incredible Adventure, and Guidance of the Dragon Balls. And that's everything you need to know about the AGL Granpa Gohan. Let's move on now to the AGL SR Invisible Man. And for an SR, he has a very, very good passive. So his leader skill is AGL type Ki plus 2, HP, attack, and defense plus 30%, super attack, invisible attack, causes supreme damage and lowers attack and defense. And his passive is invisible enemy, which is a great chance of evading enemy's attack, including super attack, which makes sense since he is the invisible man. And attack plus 30% with each enemy attack evaded up to 120%, and also disables enemy guard. So in theory, after a couple attacks, he can get up to 120% attack and still have that high chance or great chance to evade attacks. But one thing that you gotta know, right, you gotta keep in mind, is that he is an SR with SR stats, so even though he gets 120% attack and also disables enemy guard, he's still not gonna be hitting very hard. But that being said, for an SR, he is a really, really good SR, one of the best in the game, for sure, right? So moving on to his links, Infighter, Incredible Adventure, Fortune Teller, Baba's Fighter, and Guidance of the Dragon Balls. And that's all there is for the Invisible Man. And lastly, the STR Super Saiyan Vegeta Dokkan Awakening. So he awakens from this Vegeta right here. And if I'm being honest, I kind of prefer the art style of the Undokkan version better. Like, actually, like this could be the TUR and this could be the SSR, you know what I mean? So I feel like the art took a bit of a downgrade when they Dokkan Awaken him, but that's just me. Let me know in the comments down below if you agree. But anyways, Dokkan Awakening for the STR Super Saiyan Vegeta. Leader skill, all types Ki plus 3, HP, attack and defense plus 40%, super attack is Big Bang Attack, greatly raises attack and defense for 1 turn, causes supreme damage, and greatly lowers defense. And his passive is attack and defense plus 120%, plus an additional attack plus 20% with each attack received up to 80%. So that's kind of crazy, man. That's kind of crazy. Now, once again, his max stats, even when he's rainbowed, are not super impressive. I think somewhere probably in the range of like... Actually, I didn't check. I don't know. Let me see if I can find out for you guys right now. Max orbs. Okay, so max is 11,373, which is like marginally better than most free-to-play farmable characters, but still not very good. So even though he gets up to like, I don't know, 200 plus percent attack on his passive, you know, his damage is going to be just okay. Even under 170% lead, I'm sure. I haven't seen any showcases, to be honest, so I can't say for sure. I haven't done the calculations, but I would assume he can get over, you know, 1.5 million, maybe even close to 2 million, but nothing like super crazy. Nothing that's going to blow your mind, especially after seeing like all these new units we've been getting, right? But still, very, very solid. Dokkan Awakening, I don't mind it. I do have this Vegeta. He was awful pre-awakening. So yeah, this is definitely a welcome change to the character. But that's pretty much gonna do it for the video, guys. That's all I wanted to talk about. I forgot to mention these characters in the video, and I wanted to make sure that everybody was aware of what's going on and everything that we're getting for the tournament. What is going on? Why does it keep flipping back and forth? Okay, here we go. I don't know what just happened there. It's okay though. So yeah, that is all I got to talk about. Thank you guys so much for watching this video in addition to the previous one. If you haven't yet, like I said, go check it out. And you know, good luck in the upcoming world tournament, whether you're going to go super hard and try to get like top, you know, 100 or 1,000 or whatever, or you're just going to do the missions and call it a day. Either way, I hope you guys have fun. Enjoy the grind, because it's been a long time since we've had a world tournament on global, so it shouldn't be too bad this time, you know? But I do feel like, as I said in the previous video, that it's going to be a pretty competitive one. So if you're looking to rank high, you might have to work a little bit harder than normal. But that's it, guys. That's all I got to say. As always, if you enjoyed today's video, then make sure to like the damn video. And if it's your first time watching me, first time to the channel, and you like what you see, then definitely hit that big red subscribe button to join the Tiger Squad now. And while you're at it, hit that notification bell too, so that YouTube knows you want to stay up to date with all my latest content. And that's it. I'm out of here. Until next time, hope you guys have a fantastic, fantastic day. I'm Tiger with Tiger Uppercut Media, signing out.